Today, we are going to look at a BodyViz brain builder about the brain and dementia. The brain is a very complex structure, containing approximately 20 billion neurons, which allow it to perform an amazing number of functions. The brain consists of three subdivisions: the cerebrum, the cerebellum, and the brainstem. The first division of the brain is the cerebrum, which is the largest part of the brain, and is composed of the right and left cerebral hemispheres, divided by the longitudinal fissure. The two hemispheres of the cerebrum communicate with each other through the corpus callosum. Each hemisphere is composed of a highly convoluted cortex, an underlying white matter. The superficial gray matter of the cortex contains neurons and neuroglia. The neurons process and transfer the information through the nervous system. The neuroglia provide a supporting framework, isolate the neurons, and help provide an intracellular environment. The deeper white matter is composed of neuronal processes that move information from one place to another within the brain and spinal cord. The surface of the cerebrum is covered in folds called sulci and ridges called gyri. The cerebrum is subdivided into lobes according to the bone of the skull that is superficial to them. The second division of the brain is the brainstem, which is composed of four structures and is responsible for regulating most of the body's automatic functions that are essential for life. The diencephalon connects the brainstem to the cerebrum, and almost all of the sensory and motor information of the CNS synapses within here. The mesencephalon, also known as the midbrain, contains the motor nuclei of the reticular formation and the sensory nuclei that processes auditory and visual stimuli. The pons, which contains ascending, descending, and transverse sensory and motor tracts, also contains motor and sensory nuclei for cranial nerves 5, 6, 7, and 8. And finally, the medulla oblongata, which is where the spinal cord connects to the brain and contains nuclei that function as the cardiovascular reflex centers, respiratory rhythmicity centers, motor and sensory relay and processing centers, and nuclei for cranial nerves 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. The third division of the brain is the cerebellum, which is divided into two cerebellar hemispheres that are connected by the vermis. However, unlike the cerebrum, the two hemispheres of the cerebellum do not communicate with each other. The cerebellum has a superficial cortex and a deep white matter, similar to the cerebrum. Each half of the cerebellum coordinates the muscular activities of its ipsilateral side. Dementia is a name used to characterize a group of symptoms affecting memory, thinking, and social abilities. Dementia is not a specific disease, but several diseases can cause dementia. Dementia generally involves memory loss. However, memory loss has other causes. Memory loss is typically an early sign of dementia. Let's learn more about the symptoms, causes, and treatments of dementia and see a patient example. Symptoms for dementia are both cognitive and psychological. Cognitive symptoms include memory loss and difficulty in the following things: communication, visual and spatial abilities, reasoning, handling complex tasks, planning and organizing, and coordination and motor function. And finally, another symptom is confusion and disorientation. Psychological symptoms can include a change in personality, depression, anxiety, paranoia, agitation, and hallucinations. Dementia usually severely affects someone's daily life. Dementia is caused by damage or loss of nerve cells and their connections to the brain. Where the damage has occurred in the brain can affect the sorts of symptoms that people experience. There are many different types of dementias and disorders that link to dementia. Next, let's hear about the treatments for dementia. The treatments depend on the type of dementia. Some types of dementia are not reversible, and other types can be reversed with treatment depending on the cause. Medications can be used to temporarily improve dementia symptoms, and therapies like occupational therapy, environmental modifications, and simplifying tasks can help dementia symptoms and behavior problems. Finally, let's take a look at a patient example of dementia. You receive your patient's file and take a look. Age 68. Gender, female, chief complaints, memory decline, and confusion. The patient's concerned daughter has brought her to the appointment today, and she explains to you how she has noticed a steady memory decline over the past couple of years with her mom. She is concerned with how severe the memory loss has become, with her forgetting and missing doctor appointments, her confusion and inability to find the right words sometimes, and a personality change she has noticed. The patient seems to not be concerned about these difficulties, but her daughter is very much so concerned. You recognize these signs as a type of dementia, so you order a CT and confirm the diagnosis. This is Alzheimer's, which is the most common cause of dementia. Sadly, this form of dementia is progressive and not reversible, but you talk to the patient and her daughter about possible treatments and therapies to help with the symptoms. This is a classic example of dementia. Like this video and subscribe to our channel for more patient case examples.